What's up, guys? It's Rob here, and today we've got to talk about the U-turn that we saw in inflation, right? Inflation was supposed to be extraordinarily elevated, according to Jen Psaki. Well, it turns out the White House just played us, right? If you actually look at this story from yesterday, you can see it right here. The White House says they expect inflation to be extraordinarily elevated in the new report, above even the expectations that we've had for inflation, which were already fairly high. Now, we just got inflation numbers coming out today, and if you look at them, they're 8.5% increases year over year in overall inflation. Now, that's not actually extraordinarily elevated compared to the expectations that we had. It is obviously much higher inflation than is desired, but we were expecting already. We already had an estimate for 8.4% inflation, and now we have 8.5%. So it's only a 0.1% increase above what we were expecting. And if you exclude food and energy from the inflation report, it's only a 6.5% increase, which is actually in line with expectations. So the White House essentially made a move yesterday to decide that they wanted to tank the market yesterday so that the market could actually move up in a big way today. If you look at the S&P, you can see that we essentially have erased all of the losses that we saw yesterday. And as this inflation report came out, stocks started moving up in a big way. We also saw the Russells, smaller market cap stocks, moving up pretty dramatically on this news as well. The Russells did even better than the overall S&P. We saw highs that were above what we'd seen the past couple of days from this. Gold even moved up on this news. And in fact, cryptos moved up as well, right? A lot of cryptos moved up. Bitcoin was one of the few that did not, but a lot of cryptos actually moved up on this news as well. And overall, the market is looking very, very green because the White House essentially played everyone, right? They said that inflation was going to be extraordinarily elevated. And to be fair, it is, in a sense, extraordinarily elevated, right? 8.5% is nothing to laugh at, right? It's a very high amount of inflation and nobody wants to see it. But at the same time, it's not that inflated. It's not that elevated compared to what we were already expecting, right? We already had estimates of 8.4%, and 8.5% is only a 0.1% increase above that. So the White House essentially made people's expectations so bad that when the real report came out and it was only moderately or slightly worse than what people were expecting, it actually got taken as good news and stocks started moving up. So all things considered, it was a very interesting play on the White House's part, right? Very interesting to see them making that move. Now, if we actually look at what's causing this inflation, because obviously there is quite a bit of inflation. If you look at over the long term, we have just been moving up and up and up, and we could continue to move up for a couple of more months. Reason being, the main things that are creating this increased cost of inflation are oil, okay? Gasoline and oil. Those are the two big items on this list for March of 2022. We're seeing oil up 22% month over month, gas up 18% month over month, and energy as a whole, 11% month over month. Now, this is driving a lot of the inflation, whereas other categories are actually starting to come down. We're looking at used cars and trucks moving down 3.8%, and other categories are much more subdued, right? You're only seeing, if you say, look at food, all items, food is right here, food at home is only up 1.5%, food away from home up 0.3%. Now, nobody wants to see a 1.5% increase in food, but it's nothing compared to the 18% and 22% increase that we're seeing in energy and gas and oil, right? There's quite a bit of inflation that's being caused mostly by those. And if those numbers were taken down a little bit, then we would see an overall much less sharp increase in the current inflation rate, which unfortunately just continues to keep rising and rising. Now, what's going on with oil is actually today it's up, but over the past couple of weeks, we have been moving down with the price of oil, right? We've gotten below $100 per barrel. Over the long term, we have been uptrending, but a lot of these price increases that we've seen over the past couple of months have been due to the situation in Russia and Ukraine, right? As Russia invaded Ukraine, we placed a lot of sanctions on Russia. A lot of companies decided to self-sanction and not take Russian oil. And we overall just saw a dramatic decrease in the amount of oil that was flowing out of Russia into the rest of the world. And that caused a big rise in the price of oil. Now, as the situation resolves itself, we may end up seeing some companies start to accept Russian oil again. We may see some sanctions loosen. We'll have to see how that all plays out, right? Nobody can say exactly for sure. It really depends on what goes on in Ukraine over the next couple of weeks and months. If Russia does decide to back off, that could be good for the price of oil. If they continue to keep on going as they have been, then obviously that wouldn't be the best situation for the price of oil or for anyone living in Ukraine, right? Nobody wants to see that happen. Everyone would like the situation to resolve itself. But we're looking at a situation where the price of oil is closely tied to that situation. And I'm expecting the price of oil will not remain elevated for years, right? I'm thinking that the price of oil will eventually resolve itself as the situation resolves itself. And a lot of this inflation could, you know, the Fed always said it, a lot of this inflation specifically could be transitory. Now, I know that's something we've heard before, but the oil inflation could be transitory, right? A lot of the other things, the increase in the cost of food, the increase in the cost of just things that you're buying, electronics and whatnot, that may remain somewhat elevated for some time, that we might not get back. But due to this being a geopolitical event, right, the increased cost of oil due to the sanctions, it's not as if there's a permanent decrease in the amount of oil out there, right? There's still the same amount of oil that exists. It's just how that oil can be distributed, right? People don't want to buy it from a big supplier right now. And that means that the price is temporarily a bit higher. But I would expect, similar to what we're seeing with used cars and trucks right now, how their inflation rate is actually dropping. We're actually seeing some deflation. I would expect that by the end of this year, we could see oil prices and gas prices moving down in big ways. And we could actually see deflation in those areas. Overall, we'll still have much higher prices in a lot of the economy, right? This inflation isn't going to go away just because oil and gas is getting cheaper. Not all of this was caused just by oil and gas. So we'll still see relatively elevated inflation. That's why I'm still a bull on gold. I still think gold is a decent investment. And you can see over the past year, it's actually been doing fairly well. So I'm still bullish on gold. And I think that gold is still a potential way to go, right? Now, getting a little bit off of gold, talking about the last thing that we've got to talk about, the last reason why I think oil might be going down in price, Biden just waived the ethanol rule, okay? So essentially what happened with this was ethanol could only make up 10% of the gasoline blend that you buy at a gas station, right, before, because there was some regulation about it due to how much smog they didn't want to put into the atmosphere. Now he's waiving that rule. He's changing it to 15%. So upping the amount of ethanol or, you know, plant-based gasoline that people can have in gasoline at gas stations to lessen the demand for Russian oil, right? Essentially, we're going to be able to use more ethanol or corn-derived gasoline to fuel our cars. So it'll give a little hit to the environment, but it will lower the cost of gasoline by an estimate of around 10 cents per gallon at 2,300 gas stations. So overall, that is another little pressure that could be lowering the cost of gas, could potentially be helping out the stock market at the moment. But that's what we've got going on right now. We're looking at a situation where inflation's running pretty rampant, but the White House really played everybody and made it seem like it was going to be a lot worse than it was. So stocks are actually moving up. And I think that over the long term, we'll probably continue to see stocks move up. I mean, hopefully, this is the end of the little dip that we were on. Hopefully, especially in smaller market cap stocks, we can see these stocks rebound in a fairly big way and come back to where they were over the course of 2021. And those are just my hopes, my thoughts on the market, not financial advice for anyone out there. If you guys appreciate the video, feel free to subscribe to the channel. And other than that, guys, have a great day. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.